بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على رسول الله، أما بعد، حياكم الله أيها الأحبة في الله وبياكم وجعل جنة الفردوس مأوانا ومأواكم. My dear brothers and sisters, a brother sent me a video of our brother Muhammad Hijab and Ali Da'w. May Allah guide us and guide them. These brothers, claiming that Allah is aiding them. وكم من شخص يدعي بأن الله معه والأمر ليس كذلك. How many people think Allah is with them, but in reality Allah is not with them. فكثير من كفار قريش أو غير قريش من أعداء الرسل كانوا يدعون بأن الله معهم وأنهم على الطريق الصحيح. They used to claim that Allah is with them, like the Nasara, the Christians, they believe Allah is with them. لكن في الواقع غير صحيح. In reality, that is not true. إن الله مع الذين اتقوا. Allah with those who have piety and righteousness. إن الله مع الذين آمنوا. Allah with the believers, the true believers. The shade, my dear brothers and sisters, نعوذ بالله من الخذلان. We ask Allah and we seek refuge with Allah from Allah to let us down while we think Allah is with us. So Muhammad Hijab and Ali Da'wa, there's a clip they took out. They never put the whole clip. And they start slandering me, backbiting me, even though they accuse me of that. But it's halal for them. It's okay. And they try to justify it too. It's halal to have a channel dedicated to Muslims. But let us start with مقدمة ألا وهي with introduction, and that is Allah سبحانه وتعالى ذكر في كتابه. Allah mentioned in his noble book ما يلفظ من قول إلا لديه رقيب عتيد. Whatever we're going to utter, Allah will write it down. Either it's going to be for us or against us. So my dear brothers and sisters, Allah also mentioned وإذا قلتم فعدلوا. If you speak, then speak with justice. Because speaking against your Muslim brother, the asl is haram. It's not permissible. Yes, it's permissible in some situations. قال العلامة ابن دقيق العيد. ابن دقيق العيد, may Allah have mercy upon him, mentioned فيه صنفان على شفة من حفرة النار. There's two types of people standing on, or they are on the edge of the fire. Who are they? Those who speak against people. That includes judges and other than judges. And I can't remember who the other was, subhanAllah. You know, but one of them that's speaking against your Muslim brother or sister. Because the asl, the honor of your Muslim brother or sister is sacred. طيب. So, alhamdulillah, Ibn Taymiyyah, may Allah have mercy upon him, said, لابد على الإنسان أو على المسلم إذا تكلم في شخص أن يتكلم بالعلم والصدق والعدل. طيب, it's upon the Muslim. If he is going to speak against someone, he has to speak with knowledge, truthfulness, and justice. ليس بالجهل ولا الكذب والظلم. It's not with ignorance or lies and injustice. أو كما قال. The shade, my dear brothers and sisters, we should not have a deep hatred against anyone, because sometimes, because of our deep hatred, we end up slandering people, oppressing people, falling into injustice, because why? We have a blind hatred. That's why our love for Allah's sake and our hatred for Allah's sake is based upon justice. For example, if I hate the enemies of Islam, I'm not allowed to lie against them. That is no justification for me to lie against them. There is no justification to oppress them, to rob them, kill them, steal from them. Allahu Akbar. انظر إلى عدل الإسلام. Look at the justice of Islam. The shaykh, my dear brothers and sisters, there is a person called Salih Hamama, which Muhammad Hijab and Ali Da'wa put up claiming I'm aiding LGBTQ against him. Wallahi Muhammad Hijab, I will not forgive you for this video. I will start also with this. والله الذي لا إله غيره ولا رب سواه جل وعلا. I'm not going to forgive you anymore. You are علي. I did forgive you in the past when you lied against me, slandered me. And الميعاد عند الله تبارك وتعالى عند الجبار سبحانه وتعالى. Because yes, I used to forgive you. But Sheikh Uthaymeen mentioned it's not befitting for a Muslim to keep forgiving someone who's known to keep lying against him, lying and lying. He said rather that's from foolishness. If I don't remember exactly the wording. So remember this. We stand before Allah. LGBTQ. And guess my Muslim brother? Are you mentally disturbed? Are you be smoking crack? Ya kadab. طيب. Are you مجنون? أعوذ بالله من ذلك. So the shahid, this individual called Saleh Hamama from Saudi. My dear brothers and sisters, to understand the context of the clip that they took out of context and then even put up the whole clip. This individual, he's been inciting hatred and even violence, revolution against some Muslim countries, more specifically Saudi. And when he was asked why you left Saudi, he said because I saw evil in Saudi. Listen to this point very well to understand what I did to him. So he said he left Saudi. His iman is too strong, brother. He couldn't see the evil in Saudi, miskin. You know, you think, okay, you in Saudi, you saw evil, go to Mecca, akhi. You Saudi, go to Mecca, akhi. جنب الكعبة, اجلس هناك. Sit next to the Kaaba, مدينة, مسجد نبوي. No, our brother, he saw evil in Saudi and he couldn't forbid the evil. He said, Allahu Akbar, for my iman to become more stronger and to forbid the evil, I'm coming to Britain. I know some of you be probably laughing, like thinking, what is going on in bloody dunya? In this bloody dunya, what's going on, man? Like in Britain, when we start feeling our iman is down, where we go? Either masjid or to make a stronger fly to Saudi, to Kaaba, Mecca, masjid Nabawi, Medina. No, sahibuna, our friend, no, it's the opposite. Yep. So I met him. He's been challenging me online. You know, I met him face to face, like the real man, face to face. So I said to what I was going to establish to him when I said to him, speak against LGBTQ, I want to establish that he will not do it because there's certain evils in this country you cannot forbid openly because we'll put you into problems or troubles. All right? So if he accept that, then his argument for leaving Saudi is invalid because you left Saudi because you couldn't forbid the evil. You came to Britain when there's evil everywhere and you cannot forbid it, but you're still here. So please make this make sense for me now. Is it me I'm losing my mind or what? My dear brothers and sisters, may Allah bless you all. I mean, there is some Muslims come here, they say kind of war, you know, or for other issues. It's not my business. Barakallahu alaykum. The advice I give to Muslims that come to this country, learn English language and give da'wah. Learn, not just English language, learn knowledge. Utilize yourself being here to do something, get you closer to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But don't come to Britain and you are in Britain when there's a shirk, paganism, disbelief, and other evils, and you are silent about it, and you know you cannot forbid it, certain evils, but you left Saudi because you cannot forbid the evil. That's why I'm showing النفاق, the hypocrisy of this individual. That's the first thing. Secondly, this person, my dear brothers and sisters, he believes in the crazy things, by the way. So I said to him, enjoy the good, forbid the evil. He said, it's only for the Muslims. Only for the Muslims. And you can check our TikTok videos, clips, how I've exposed him. So I said to him, no, it's for both. He said, no, it's only for the Muslims. I said, what is the greatest evil? Let me show you here. I said, what is the greatest evil? He said, Tawheed. I said, Tawheed. He said, yeah. I said, Shirk. He said, yeah, Shirk, Shirk. Okay. So I didn't know. I want to know why Muhammad Hijab and Ali Da'wah never put up that clip when this person twice said, Tawheed is the worst evil thing. طيب, my dear brothers, here for you to hear it.
ما
I will translate for you, even though I don't know Arabic, you know. I don't know how to speak Arabic and I don't know Arabic. So even though the Arabic language is my mother tongue, but I don't know how to speak it. So I don't know what language I was speaking with my families and my friends back home and even here. I don't know what language, maybe Chinese I've been speaking. But Muhammad Hijab knows, you know. He knows it. And I would advise you to watch Muhammad Hijab speaking Arabic in one of the podcasts in Saudi. Allah ya khay. La yufarriqu bayn al-mudhakkar wal-mu'annath. He cannot differentiate between a masculine, feminine and masculine. خلقبطها. خلط لها دين أمها. He mixed everything, ya khay. Anyway, so he said to me, is forbidden the evil and enjoying the good for both the Muslims and non-Muslims? I said, yes. He said, wallah, you're wrong. It's only for the Muslims. Only for the Muslims. So watch, I'm going to show you the shahid. I said to him, what is the worst evil? He said, tawheed. I said, tawheed. He said, yes. This guy's a skin that you can see, he's like panicking. I said, shirk, said, shirk, shirk. Anyway, then I showed him that the worst evil is shirk billah. So the prophets and messengers came to forbid the evil and enjoy the good. So they came to non-Muslims. Lut alayhi salam, Shu'aib, and the other Anbiya, wa Rasul alayhi salatu wa salam. Shared, my dear brothers and sisters. So this individual, why he wants to specify or restrict enjoying the good and forbid the evil only to the Muslims? Because the people that are going after him online, they're telling him, hang on, you told us you left Saudi. You told us you left Saudi because you saw evil. And I'm because people go Saudi. Don't let people lie to you. If you go Saudi, every woman is naked and everyone's dancing. It's not like that. Even Algeria. Alhamdulillah, people pray, mashallah. There is khair. Anyway, side went. So they said to him, you said you saw evil. You left, but you're in Britain. And there's evil everywhere. You have a shirk, LGBTQ, all of that, but you're silent about it. So to escape from that, he said, no, enjoy the good and forbid the evil only for the Muslims. This guy is mentally not well. And we know what is very interesting, my dear brothers and sisters. People with this aqidah of this individual in Britain, they're not allowed to speak out. They will lock them out, by the way. Why I'm saying that, in the Western world, they have this mentality that you're allowed to come and you're allowed to speak against any country, but don't speak against us. Don't incite hatred against us or violence against us. I remember when I went to the mosque in Finsbury Park back in 2001 or two, early 2000, and I was inside the mosque and there was a notice saying that Alhamdulillah we have killed, I can't remember the number of the soldiers, Algerian soldiers, Muslim. I said to the brother that brought me inside, I was not even practicing, we were just praying on off. I said, Akhi, let's go out. No way. I said, brother, these people killed some of my family, you know. These people are praising the terrorists. And in this country, they're walking freely. Then what happened? With same people, when they start turning against Britain and France, they said they are terrorists. But we as Muslims, we said, no, they were terrorists before attacking you. Ah, they are terrorists only when they attack you. But when they attack other countries, they're okay. This guy, same thing. That's why, my dear brothers and sisters, there's many people who claim that they have hate, love for Islam and ghira, they are honey trap. They are being used. Wallahi ladhi la ila ghira. Wala rabba siwa jalla wa ala. And we know them. Barakallahu feekum. One of them openly said it when they took him to USA. He said he was working for MI5. Ya khuya. MI5, and he was accused, while he was working for MI5, he was accusing the scholars, Salafi scholars for dollars. See how they do it? And it's a tactic of the evil ones. While they're doing evil, they start accusing other people of evil to remove the focus from themselves and the attention. Allahu Akbar. The shahid, my dear brothers and sisters, I don't want to make this video longer, but I have to because there's certain things I want to explain, to understand. Anyway, so this individual, that's why I said to him, say it. Because I wanted to show him he cannot say it. I knew it. Because he told me I'm not going to say it. So, I understand why. So my point here, you are a hypocrite because there's an evil here you cannot forbid, but you're still here. And also, his auntie's husband, Safar Hawali, who make takfir in Muslim countries because they're allies with Britain, allies with America. Even this guy, he believes the same thing. But he came to Britain and he said he doesn't want to live under a taghut. So he came to Britain. I don't know if the British government taghut or not to him. I mean, like, if they're taghut, so hang on again. You left taghut, but you came to taghut to seek help from taghut. MashaAllah, ya akhi, wallahi, majaneen, they think we're some hamir, we just believe them. We don't believe you, alhamdulillah. But the other people believe you. Anyway, my dear brothers and sisters, this guy, he had someone with him. To show you, alhamdulillah, I'm a man of honor, alhamdulillah. There was a guy with him who was recording him. So while we're recording, we did record him too. He said, akhi Shamsi, don't put me online because I want to go back to Saudi. I don't want to face any problems. I said, I promise you, I want to do it. I joked to him first, I said, I'm going to do it. He said, please. I said, no. I said, akhi, I want to do it. But I advise you, stay away from this guy. I don't want to cause trouble to you. You know, I want khair for you. Even Salih Hamama, this individual, may Allah guide us and guide him. We ask Allah to guide him because he's been used by the enemies of Islam to incite violence in the Muslim countries, to see the Muslims killing each other, Muslim women getting raped and so on. While some of them will run away and come to the Western world. Subhanallah. Why do you want to see this in Muslim countries? What I'm saying, if you see evil in Muslim countries, forbid it. If you cannot, don't say, I have to. Otherwise, do it in the Western world, while in the Western world. Forbid the evil. Don't say to me, no, I can't do it. Ah, so you hypocrite. My point here is, what I have noticed and observed, and it's been established to me, that these type of people, they are a murji'ah with the Western government. Khawarij with the Muslim governments. Murji'ah here. Subhanallah. Anyway, my dear brothers and sisters, now about me saying Allah LGBTQ is worse than Allah has a son. طيب. Now let me get you the video that I said no, Allah has a son is worst. Where is the video? I'll show you the video, no problem. So he's asking me and he's irritating me. Why is asking me? تفضل. I said to him, Allah in the world أعظم is greater, worst. That's the clip. That's the same clip that they showed you, Muhammad Hijab and Ali Dawah. Same clip, my dear brothers and sisters. Here I repeat again. ما هي أعظم المثلية أم الله عند ولد؟ What is worst and greater, LGBTQ or people قوم لوط or the actions of people of Lut or Allah has a son? Allah عنده ولد هي أعظم يا محمد حجاب علي دعوة هي أعظم is worst. طيب. But also I said to him, when you say what LGBTQ are doing is from Allah is worse too. Understand? But the other one is worst. That's the one, yeah? Another one again to show you, my dear brothers and sisters. Even when I said to him, when the clip that Muhammad Hijab Ali Dawah put, I said, when you say the other one is worse, well, I want to emphasize that is worse too. Don't negate that. Both of them is worse, but the other one is greater, but that one is worse too. To prove that, again, I repeated it twice. So he comments after when I said the one that when you say that the LGBTQ is from Allah, that is worst. So I explained to him what I meant. Watch this, yeah? So he said, Shamsi is saying the other one is worst. I said, no, Allah's word is worst. But also the other one is worst. Understand? But no way, Allah, no doubt that the one who's Allah's son is greater. But imagine that both of them, the same thing. Because we know that there's no nation been destroyed like the people of Lot. So I repeat again. Hey, I said, no, ولد. كذلك the other one, I want to mention, both of them is worse, but the other one is worse. But don't forget the other one is worse too. I mean, there's no doubt about it. Barakallahu feekum. Anyway, my dear brothers and sisters, Muhammad Hijab never put up the whole thing. And even accused me that I'm aiding them. That's the biggest lie. And So my advice to you, Muhammad Hijab, you be let down by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala because you're not sincere, you're not Ali Dawah. In your reputation against me, you have a deep hatred. And alhamdulillah, my English is sufficient for me to utilize it to convey the message of Islam. And by Allah's permission, and by Allah's tawfiq, first and the last, many people have accepted Islam through my da'wah. And of course, Allah is the first and the last. You know, and then my speech, and I do speak English, alhamdulillah. I mean, like my English, like I said, is sufficient for me to utilize it to convey the message. I speak to different people from different background. Not long ago, I had a nice conversation with the MP about which one is the best solution for us. Is it a Sharia or democracy? We had a nice discussion, respectful discussion. At the end of the discussion, he admitted it. He said, yes, what you just said, it made clear sense to me. And I gave him a book about a sacred freedom by our teacher, Hanif Oliver. May Allah guide him. But I'm not claiming I am the expert of English language. Likewise, I'm not an expert in Arabic language. However, Muhammad Hijab, you Arabic, wallahi, when I listen to you, I feel like I'm listening to someone who's still in the ibtida'i, primary school. When you're Arabic, aslan, Allah yahdik, may Allah guide you. Anyway, but like I said, I've forgiven you many times. I will not forgive you again. I will stand before Allah until you take down the video and repent from your life. Because clearly, I said, Allah in the world is worst. Tayyib. But I want to emphasize the other one worse too. Barakallahu feekum. So it's clear. I repeat it twice. Even Hamama himself, that person, he said, Shamsi is saying the Mithliya is worse than Allah's son. I said, no, Allah's son is worse. Clearly, barakallahu feekum. But I want to mention the other one, you should not negate it. Because especially they say it's from Allah. Allah told them, A'udhu billahi min dhalik. That's why the Salaf mentioned, Allah never destroyed nations like the people of Lut. Why? Even the other nations had shirk, which is worse. Because that which they were doing is known that is against the fitrah. Like Shaykh Isa ibn Taymiyyah, he said about some shirk issues, they have a shubah. Yep. But I can't remember, I have to look, one of the Salaf said, as for this one, there's no shubah about it. Subhanallah. Let alone say it's from Allah. Na'udhu billahi min dhalik. Allahumma sallim, sallim. So my dear brothers and sisters, I hope it's clear to you. May Allah bless you all. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us from those who follow the Quran and the Sunnah inwardly and outwardly, and to forgive our sins, and to bless us in these first 10 days. And I do apologize for making this video because I had to make it. People have contacted me, say, look what they're saying about you. Please clarify. That's why I'm clarifying. Barakallahu feekum. Jazakum Allah khair. And before I finish, by the way, I'm not infallible. I'm a human being. But guess what? There's many videos we made against Muhammad Hijab when he said some kufri statements. Likewise, Ali, we agreed with the kufri statement that Allah is a son. Yes. Or Jesus is God. They agreed with it. Yes. But they have not come out and made tawbah from it. Nothing. Anyway, assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.